Welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hobney Assembly Center here on the campus of Grambling State University. Santoria Black along with Leon Thomas III bringing you exciting Southwestern Athletic Conference basketball action tonight. The Grambling Tigers taking on PVAMU A&M University. And why is this game so important? One of the reasons is because when you look at where Grambling was right in the middle of the pack just about a week ago before they played Southern, now they are fighting for their tournament lives. They are now 5-7 in conference play, while PVAMU A&M is five and five, and one of the things that they're going to have to do tonight is remember they've got to play defense.
Definitely, Santoria. Oftentimes, the Tigers get caught up in the rhythm of the game, find themselves falling behind early, having to dig out of a hole, and once they get close enough to close the gap, they seem to have run out of steam. They've got to start out strong. Nigel Ribeiro did not play last game. I expect him to have a big game tonight. And I expect Avril Upa to continue to do the things he's been doing. Double-figure points, double-figure rebounds, getting blocks, getting assists, getting steals, doing what the big man needs to.
Absolutely. And the other thing they're going to have to do is to make sure that they contain this PVAMU A&M team, because their leading scorer right now is Zachary Hamilton, who has 15 points a ball game. But, you know, the biggest thing here is this team has struggled a little bit on the rebounding side at times, and that's why they're 5-6 right now. The Panthers right now in the middle of a two-game losing streak. They lost at Texas Southern, and, of course, that was their only game they had last weekend. Then, of course, they lost against Jackson State University on this past Saturday, 78-69. So this is a game that they were definitely
the Southwestern Athletic Conference encourages and promotes good sportsmanship by student-athletes, coaches, and spectators. We ask for your cooperation by supporting the participants and officials in a positive manner.
And the other thing is they would be right there, right down with Alabama A&M and Mississippi Valley in order to try to get that last spot.
Definitely. And the
ladies and gentlemen, it's game day here in Grambling, Louisiana. The Grambling State University Department of Athletics would like to welcome you to the Frederick C. Hobney Assembly Center for the game today between your GSU Tigers and the Prairie View Panthers. GSU President Richard J. Gallo and Director of Athletics Paul Bryant would like to welcome all alumni and fans of Grambling and hope that you enjoy the game. And now let's get our starting lineups for tonight's game. Let's introduce first the visitors from Prairie View University. At guard, number one, Troy Thompson. At guard, number five, Tevin Bellinger. At guard, number 11, Jadante Blakely. At forward, number 14, Zachary Hamilton. And at forward, number 21, Sharon Jett. The Prairie View Panthers are coached by Byron Smith, assisted by Kenyon Curry, Landon Bussey, and Derek Daniels.
He was a player of the week, averaging a double-double despite two losses on the road. And I might add, Alcorn is now the hottest team in the conference, seven in a row coming into the night.
Definitely. I mean, these guys, when Prairie View makes up their mind to play, they can really do that. And basketball is a game of rhythm and runs, and it seems that they've gotten into the right rhythm at the right time, and Grambling has got to find their momentum again. But these guys are on a win streak, we're on a lose streak, so we're going to have to fight hard to turn the tide tonight. And you know, we've got Ramon Brown, Richwood's own, who is probably the best athlete and probably the best overall player on the team, along with Irvin Mitchell. Those two guys, as they go, the Tigers seem to go. And we've got to get some good play off our bench. The last game, we saw some great play from Drake Wilkes, who's a starter now, who was coming off of the bench. But we've got some guys coming off the bench that really, really give us good minutes. Number 24, Deontay Jones, who's another big body at 6'6", 215, lefty with a really sweet stroke. And another lefty with a sweet stroke is the kid from Peabody from Alexandria, Louisiana, Carlton Lowe. He's a senior, 6'2", 185, comes in, gives us great D, gives us that great jump shot. He can knock down the three at any given time. And even in the backcourt, we've got Ivy Smith Jr., who's a freshman, but plays some really, really good minutes, along with the transfer from Farmerville, Xavier Solari.
All right, looking at the PVAMU A&M starting lineup, they will start Troy Thompson at one guard. He's a 6'4" guard. from Oakland, California. Tevin Bellinger, who's third on the team in scoring, averaging about 10.5 points a ball game. Yeah, he will start as he's out of Hutto, Texas, went to Jacksonville College. Jatanta Blakely, the 6'2 senior from Lake Charles. Zachary Hamilton, the leading scorer from Houston. And Sharon Jett, the 6'8 junior from Hartsville, South Carolina. For the Grambling Tigers, Mitchell, Brown, Cormier, Ugba, and Drake Wilkes will start. Here's the opening tip. It comes down to Prairie View A&M, and we are underway here in tonight's second game of the doubleheader. Prairie View A&M with a basketball. They look to the right side. Raymond Brown playing tough defense on the right side. Now here's Chase Cormier. Cormier now fighting around the pick. Top of the key. The ball goes out to Hamilton, the leading scorer. The shot is up, partially blocked by Avril Ugba, and here come the Grambling Tigers.
Ugba already on the boards, and we've got to see him crash hard tonight, all night. As he hits the boards, it frees up opportunities for us to get fast break points. He played an outstanding game on Saturday, and I'm looking to see more of that from him tonight.
Tigers knock the ball out of bounds. It goes back to Prairie View A&M University. Early in our game, 0-0, 19-27 remaining here in the first half. Cormier trying to get the ball inside, and it goes out of bounds off of Prairie View again, back to Grambling. 14 seconds still left on the shot clock for the Grambling Tigers. Avril Ugba gets the ball, and he's going up, gets fouled, and the foul is going to go against Sharon Jett. That'll be his first personal and the team's first. It is a shooting foul.
And as we take a look at the replay, inbounds to Ugba, and he does not hesitate, goes aggressively to the basket. I like what I see starting off already from Ugba. Ugba being aggressive on the boards, on the glass, and offensively as he knocks down the first free throw.
And free throws are so important for this Grambling Tiger basketball team. We talked about the free throw shooting woes that they had against the Southern University Jaguars on the season. This team is shooting about 63% on the year. Avril Ugba, 2-for-2 at the line. And the Tigers on top early by the score of 2-0. Prairie View with the basketball. Controlling is Jadonta Blakely from Lake Charles, Louisiana. Now right side to Thompson, shoots a three-pointer, up no good. Chase Cormier with the rebound. Cormier will set the offense for the Grambling Tigers. Sean Walker, head coach of the Grambling Tigers. 10-15 overall, 5-7 here on the season. Trying to break the three-game losing streak. Irvin Mitchell now with the ball, defended by Jadonta Blakely. Mitchell just inside the three-point line. The shot is up, it's no good. And the rebound by Tevin Bellinger.
Great defense that time by PV, getting a hand in Irvin Mitchell's face as we see the knockdown three from Troy Thompson. Sweet stroke on that, Jay.
And that's the first basket of the ball game for Prairie A&M. 3-2 is our score. The game is being broadcasted live, not only on ESPN 97.7 and on the Grambling Sports Radio Network, but also on GSU TV through the YouTube channel. Here's Raymond Brown from Monroe with the shot up, no good. Avril Ugba going right back in, getting the bucket, and drawing the foul.
Again, Santori, as we take a look at the replay, Ramon Brown missing the layup, but Avril Ugba crashing the boards hard. I think that's his second rebound. And again, he's back at the line, this time to complete the old-fashioned three-point play. I'm liking what I'm seeing from Ugba. He's peaking at the right time in the season.
20 points and 11 rebounds in the game against Texas Southern University in a tight loss. 77-70 was the final there. Prairie View with the basketball, light press shown by Grambling. Blakely with the ball to Hamilton, back to Blakely. Top of the circle. Now right side to Hamilton, back to Blakely. He'll drive, he'll shoot, and kisses it off the window with the left hand. And it's now a 5-3 ball game, Grambling on top, with Grambling in Prairie View tied.
That's a solid aggressive move from Jadonta Blakely. Blakely just driving hard to the left and kissing it high off the window with the left hand. Great move.
Chase Cormier now with the basketball to Irvin Mitchell, top of the key. Mitchell bounced pass to Avril Ugba. The shot is up by Ugba. He has all 7 points for Grambling State University so far. 7-5 is the score.
Great play, just giving it up to Ugba just inside the three-point line, and he knocks it down with ease. Ugba has really been playing well. I'm liking what I'm seeing from this young man in the post.
Kick out on the pass to Zachary Hamilton, who shoots a three from the left side. It's good. 7-8-7 now the score. Grambling trailing now by 1 point, 16:50 remaining in the first half of play.
Zachary Hamilton hitting the three. He's from Houston, Texas, and shooting that thing like he can't wait to get back home to the SWAG tournament, because that was a good-looking stroke.
Irvin Mitchell goes up for the shot, and he's fouled. And that foul is going to be charged to Tevin Bellinger. That's his first personal and the second team on Prairie View. Incidentally, not only is it the second team foul, but it's also the second time that they fouled a player in the act of shooting. Irvin Mitchell with the first free throw. It's up and good.
Irv is a solid player, very athletic. He's a senior from a New York, New York. Plays very good, can knock down the stroke. Great athlete and plays great defense as we see him knock down the second free throw.
2-for-2 at the line, and it's now a 9-to-8 ball game. Grambling on top. Prairie View now with the basketball. Three-pointer on the way by Thompson. Off the mark, no good. Tip-in is up and no good by Tevin Bellinger, and the Grambling Tigers get the ball back. It's going to be a traveling violation charge to Averill Ugba.
Yeah, he was coming down on the break, and Cormier kicked it to him as we take a look at the replay here, and he couldn't get his feet together before he got a handle on the ball, turnover. But a smart play by Cormier to hit the trailer.
Chase Cormier will take care of the point. Defending Blakely. Nice switch by the Tigers. Blakely in the paint, looking for a shot, up and good. Boy, he had to fight for that shot as he kept the ball the entire possession for Prairie View. 10-9 our score, and Grambling trailing now by 1 point. Irv Mitchell now calling out for the pick. Gets it out to Raymond Brown to Chase Cormier. Cormier was turned back inside, gives it to Ugba, goes up, and he's fouled again.
Again, this is Chase Cormier. Penetrating, look at this great move, spin move, getting into the lane, dishing off to the big man, and Ugba does not waste any time aggressively attacking the basket, forcing the Panthers to foul.
Timeout on the floor with the score, Grambling trailing Prairie View A&M University 10-9 with 15:40 remaining here in this first half of play. We'll take this 1 minute timeout. 1 minute, you're listening to the Grambling Sports Radio Network. Back to the Frederick C. Hamdi Assembly Center here on the campus of Grambling State University in the Pawnee Hills of North Louisiana. Tigers trail 10-9. Averill Ugba at the free throw line hits the first free throw. I tell you what, that's one of the things that Coach Walker has been discussing and talking about and preaching about like a Baptist preacher. You got to hit the free throws.
Definitely. That's been a big, big Achilles heel for the Tigers. One game they came up short. Maybe 1 or 2 points. Sam missed 16 free throws in that game. That's unacceptable. And so these guys have been paying much more attention to the charity stripe as we see Carlton Lowe in the game and Irvin Mitchell getting a breather.
Prairie View with the basketball. Blakely to Hamilton. Three-point opportunity, no good. 11-10, Grambling on top. 15-15 remaining in the first half. Chase Cormier now with the basketball in between the circles. He's defended by Blakely out high. Out of Blake Wilkes. Wilkes now to Carlton Lowe coming into the game. Left side to Raymond Brown. 7 left on the shot clock. Brown looking, trying to find something. Goes up for the shot, no good. Rebound on the floor, and it's grabbed by Prairie View A&M University. Blakely down the floor, going up for the shot. Oh, they're going to call a blocking foul on Carlton Lowe.
And Ugbo with a big block from behind as we take a look at GSU TV's replay. Ugbo trailing, not giving up. Ugbo has shown a lot of energy, Santoria, in these past three ball games. I don't know what happened, but it seems as if he's found a rhythm, and he can be the catalyst through which this team plays.
Well, you know, when you look at some of the point production that Ugbo's had in the last few ball games, you look at Mississippi Valley, he had 13 rebounds. You look at Southern University, 26 points, 17 rebounds. He had 18 points, 12 rebounds against Alcorn, and then 20 and 11 against Texas Southern University. So he's been in double digits in rebounds and or points for the last five ball games.
Yeah, Ugba's been doing the job. He's been he's like Sherwin Williams. That's good paint work. He's been crashing the boards a lot, and that's what I like to see. And his ability to score, I was impressed with that. I hadn't seen that part of his game. But the past two games and thus far tonight, he's shown a propensity to be able to score pretty effortlessly.
Irvin Mitchell now will check back into the ball game. Blake Wilkes comes out, and that's someone else that has added a little bit more of a dimension in the ball game, as Najee Ribeiro did not play in their last ball game against Texas Southern. He's not started tonight. And at some point in time, he'll probably get in.
Definitely. Ribeiro, who was freshman of the year last year, is definitely going to get a shot to get in the game tonight. But, yeah, man, this kid, Drake Wilkes, he's sweet. He's got a nice J, and he's an amazing athlete, you know. He'll catch you off guard, and if you're not ready for it, he'll catch that alley-oop on you.
Rambling with the basketball, inside pass from Irvin Mitchell to Avril Ugba. Ball is tipped by Prairie View, and coming away with the basketball is Hamilton, and it's going to be looks like a foul charge to Prairie View, and that's going to be charged to Zachary Hamilton, first personal, third team.
Hamilton with the push-off, but again, Ugba trailing on defense and blocking the shot, not giving up on it. Just his aggressiveness on the defensive end on the board and the way that he's attacking the glass. I've been very impressed with Avril Ugba as of late.
And it's going to be a jump ball. Possession goes to, looks like, Grambling. Into the ball game now for Prairie View A&M University will be number 22, Shaquille Preston. And Preston, out of New Orleans, Louisiana, transferred to Prairie View A&M University from Howard Community College. As a matter of fact, Byron Smith from Prairie View A&M University, three players from the state of Louisiana. Shaquille Patterson, of course, Jadonta Blakely. And there's a shot up, and it's good. That's by Raymond Brown.
Yeah, Brown sneaking in on behind the defense on the inbounds for an easy layup.
And a near steal. Ugba grabs it and gets it into Irvin Mitchell. Great defense by Ugba. Here's Mitchell with the shot. It's up. It's no good. And the rebound by Chase Cormier.
Again, Avril Ugba with great defense. Got his hand on the ball. Got the steal. And got the fast break started.
Ugba, nice pass to Raymond Brown, who got him, who was just ahead of the defender, and it's now 15-12, Grambling on top, 13-24, remaining in the first half of play.
Again, Ugba to Brown, great defense by Ugba, and then making a great pass to the cutter. This kid has really been playing well.
Braveview with the basketball. Controlling is Tevin Bellinger. Nice job by Grambling. And that's going to be a travel charge to Blakely, and it goes back to the Grambling Tigers.
Yeah, number 11, Blakely, he was just moving a little bit too quickly before he put the ball on the floor. Got called for steps. Carlton Lowe's coming out of the game right now. Drake Wilkes back in for the Tigers.
12:59 remaining here in the first half of play. Tigers on top, 15-12.
And that's Ramon Brown, saying, just going on his own, dribbling in, pulling up, and knocking down the mid-range jumper. He's got in a rhythm with those two layups, so now he's feeling a little bit more comfortable being offensively aggressive.
17-12 our score. Grambling on top, 12:33 remaining in the first half of play. Prairie with the basketball. Blakely dribbling left side, now looking back towards the free throw line. He goes up for the shot, good. Well, I tell you what, Brady hanging right on in here in this ball game early on in the contest.
Yeah, this kid Blakely is something serious, saying he's a scorer and he is not bashful about trying to get his shot off. As Cormier is tied up in the trap, possession arrow favors Prairie View A&M. Coach Walker not happy about that.
Got a couple of substitutions coming in from Prairie View A&M University. They'll bring in Avery Lomax, the senior from DeSoto, Texas. And Zachary Hamilton will check back into the ball game. And number right there, 5 for 5 from the charity stripe at that last media timeout. That's exactly what the Tigers need.
Indeed, you've got to take what the Red Cross gives you.
Lomax with the basketball, driving, and it's going to be a foul on Prairie View.
Yep, that's a foul away from the basket. Yusef Yakubu, that foul is assessed to him.
We have a timeout on the floor with the score, the Grambling Tigers. On top 17-14, 11:54 remaining in this first half of play. We'll take this timeout, and we'll be right back. Welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hobley Assembly Center here on the campus of Grambling State University. The Tigers on top of Prairie View A&M, 17-14 with 11:54 remaining in this first half of play. And early on, we see Avery Lugba picking right back up where he left off against Texas Southern University.
Yeah, that was a great game this weekend. Grambling's got to get off the schneid, though. We've got to get a win, and with a three-point lead thus far, we've got to continue to build on the positive things that we've been doing thus far as a ball club.
Irv Mitchell gets it into Avery Lugba. Ooh, he almost traveled. Cormier now to Raymond Brown. He'll take the baseline. Brown goes in for the shot. No good. Avery Lugba right there to clean up. Can't get the shot, and looks like Irv Mitchell there to get the rebound. Mitchell, free throw shot. Good.
Great penetration by Mitchell. Got the rebound, looked up at the shot clock, noticed there were only 10 seconds, and he got the shooter's roll as it bounced right on the front of the rim.
Foul coming up, charge to Grambling. Looks like Raymond Brown charged with the foul. And going to the line for Prairie View A&M University is Giddings. Big number for the Tigers, 7 for 7.
And entering the game right now for the Panthers, number 5, Tevin Bellinger, coming back in after getting a breather. At the line for the Panthers, Jordan Giddings. Getting second free throw is up. Release, rotation, splash, 11-08. GSU 19, PV 16.
How about this? Both teams combined 11-for-11 at the charity stripe.
You know, that's good to see, Santoria. Those are the basic fundamentals that teams need to make themselves good teams.
Chase Cormier with the basketball near the midcourt circle. Now getting into Avery Lugba. Inside pass to Raymond Brown. Open. Nice job rolling off the pick.
Glad to see Brown being offensively aggressive, because as he plays, it fuels the rest of the team. and it also fuels him. The more baskets he gets, the more aggressively he seems to play on the defensive side of the ball, too.
Prairie View trying to find an open shot here. Bellinger with a three-pointer off the mark, no good. The rebound and the putback, no good by Blakely. And Averill Ugba coming up with the rebound. Out to Chase Cormier. Cormier will slow things down for the Grambling Tigers. Now to Irv Mitchell, who draws a double team. Raymond Brown open for a three-pointer, no good. Gets his own rebound. Brown now out to Mitchell. Left side to Cormier. Baseline to Ugba, who draws a double team. Oh, out of bounds off of Ugba. And it goes back to Prairie View.
Yeah, that's a turnover, aggressive defense. PV's trying to turn up the defense as they find themselves trailing by five right now, 21-16. Grambling has executed well on the offensive end, and they've created a lot of chaos on the defensive side of the ball.
Zachary Hamilton, the 6'4 junior, coming back into the ball game for Prairie View A&M University. Relatively quiet tonight. Prairie View with the ball. Foul coming up against Grambling. Giddings draws a foul, and that will be charged, it looks like, to Averill Ugba. That'll be his first personal, 13 foul, and PV will go to the line. Giddings will go to the line for the second time here in the ball game. 21-16 our score, 9:44 remaining in the first half of play. I thank everybody listening over in the Shreveport Market. First free throw up and good. One more at the free throw line. Carlton Lowe now coming in, giving Raymond Brown a little bit of a rest. Brown has just one foul, but leads the team with eight. Well, I should say second in scoring on the team with 8 points. Averill Ugba with nine so far in the ballgame. 2-for-2 at the line for Giddings, and now coming into the ball game for the Grambling Tigers will be Deontay Jones, the 6'6 junior from Las Vegas, Nevada.
And Jones has a nice jump shot, has some great moves off the jab step, and gives us some key minutes on the defensive end as well.
Jones to Chase Cormier. Carlton Lowe for three, no good, rattled in and out. Boy, it just looked like he was going all the way down and just came out at the last minute.
Yeah, that's the kid from Peabody.
Nice job on defense, stopping a shot. Prairie View brings the ball back out. Controlling will be Jadonta Blakely, the senior. Now to Bellinger. Back to Lomax. Now to Blakely. Blakely looking, draws a triple team. Gets it back out to Lomax. Ball is tipped. Chase Cormier coming in with the basketball. Cormier going all the way in for the shot. It's going to be no good. Oh, they call an offensive foul on Chase Cormier.
Wait. I'm thinking that they might have called a block.
Nope, they called an offensive foul.
They did call the charge on Cormier. Wow.
And Coach Sean Walker is furious. Wow, looked like it was going to be a blocking foul, and they called Chase Cormier with the charge. 8:48 remaining here in this first half of play. 21-18, Grambling on top. Bellinger with the basketball, blocked out of there. Deontay Jones controlling. Jones is going to be called on the line, and he goes out of bounds back to Prairie View A&M. Boy,
and you know,
like they had a break.
Those are the kinds of things, if you notice, Grambling was up 21-16, and now we've had three consecutive turnovers, a loose ball on the other end from Ugba, Cormier getting called for the charge, and now Jones stepping on the line. These are the kinds of things that tend to happen when we find ourselves with a little lead.
And going in for the shot, Bellinger, and it's now 21-20, 8:28 remaining in this first half of action. Chase Cormier with the basketball. Bellinger doing a great job just knifing through the defense. Carlton Lowe, bounce pass inside to Ugba. Little jump hook, good.
Averill Ugba again right at the free throw line with the mid-range jump hook, showing his offensive arsenal, giving Grambling the 23-20 lead with 8:08 remaining. Great offense thus far from Ugba and Ramon Brown.
Ball is on the floor. Blakely recovers. Back out to Hamilton. Hamilton kicks it out to Thompson. and a traveling call against Prairie View that goes back to Grambling. Timeout on the floor with the score. The Grambling Tigers on top 23-20 with 7:54 remaining here in this first half of play. We'll take this one-minute timeout. 1 minute, you're listening to the Grambling Sports Radio Network. Here to the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center on the campus of Grambling State University. 23-20 is our score, 7:54 remaining here in this first half of play. Irvin Mitchell with the basketball gets it in to now Ivy Smith Jr., who checks into the ballgame, 6-foot freshman from Seattle, Washington. Out of Carlton Lowe. Lowe back to Ivy Smith Jr. They call a timeout. Smith got caught on that sideline.
Yeah, Ivy Smith Jr. caught himself, got himself in a bad position on the baseline and got in the trap. Smith is a freshman. He's a solid point guard. He's got a lot of upside. His only fault at this point in time in his career is that he's young. Never played on the college stage, but he shows a lot of promise. He's a great ball handler, really good in the open floor and can get into the lane. As the kids would say, he's got so much sauce.
Well, I'll tell you what, one of the things that you have to be really mindful of him is that even though he's a freshman, he's got just amazing hands. His ball handling skills are incredible, and he's got quick hands on defense.
Yes, he's sweet, and he plays smart on the defensive side of the ball. He is a highlight reel waiting to happen if you catch him on the fast break.
He'll control the basketball at the point. Carlton Lowe now with the ball. Nice bounce pass to Deontay Jones. It rolls out of bounds. Back to Prairie View. Fourth turnover. No points.
Jones just could not handle that pass. Lowe hit him, but it was just, I think it might have been deflected by one of the Prairie View A&M Panther players. But again, Santoria, we've got to minimize the mistakes. Those are the things that happen that put us in a position to allow other teams to creep back into the game as we're holding on to a 23-20 lead with 7:15 remaining in the first half.
And I might add, out-rebounding Prairie View A&M 10-3 on the boards. That's going to be a travel on Giddings.
And that was great defense by Ivy Smith Jr. You know, he was moving his feet and just caused Giddings to just shuffle his feet a little bit. Great defense by the young freshman.
Smith gets the offensive call from Coach Walker. Ivy Smith Jr. with a shot up, no good. Rebounding the putback up and no good. Ball is tipped and a foul coming up, and it's going to be charged to Prairie View.
And you know, Ivy Smith just took what the defense gave him that time, Santoria. They were sagging. He saw the gap, went right to it, shot the little floater, bounced on the rim a couple of times. And Ramon Brown using that athleticism and that tenacious aggressiveness to snag the rebound, go back up and get fouled in the act of shooting. He's back at the charity stripe.
Raymond Brown with a shot up, no good. The foul was on number 4, Yusef Yakubu.
That's a fun name to say right there, Yusef Yakubu.
From Buffalo, New York, transfer from Erie Community College. And 1-for-2 at the line. And looks like Hamilton getting ready to check back in.
Yeah.
8-for-9 at the charity stripe for the Grambling Tigers. It is 24-20, Grambling on top. 6:42 remaining in the first half of play. Hamilton goes around the defense and draws a foul. That's going to be charged to Deontay Jones. That's his first person.
And Jones coming in off the bench, you know, giving up good defensive pressure, rebounds, fouls. We need that. Don't want to give up any easy basket, any easy baskets and force them to earn it from the line.
Free throw up and good. The other thing is that on both sides, for Britton and for Grambling, they're fouling and sending both to the free throw line, and they're not even in the bonus.
Well, you know, part of that is aggressive defense. You got two teams right here who are actually fighting for a position. Okay. I'm pretty sure both coaching staffs have implemented a sense of urgency into the minds of their teams. And so they're playing very aggressive on the defensive end of the ball, creating controlled chaos and not giving up any easy baskets, challenging everything.
Free throw opportunity here for Zachary Hamilton. Good. And Prairie View now 8-for-8 from the charity stripe. Grambling 8-for-9.
That's some awesome free throw shooting right there, Sam.
Man, that's the kind of free throw shooting you need, especially going down the stretch. And Yokubu, nope. This time it is number 22, Shaquille Preston from New Orleans with the foul. 16 foul.
And that's Chase Cormier being a savvy point guard, getting in front of the defender and just stopping. I mean, that's one of the oldest plays in the book. That's very, very smart basketball.
1-1 situation here. Chase Cormier going to the line. Cormier missing the free throw, shooting 46% from the charity stripe.
Here's that's Hamilton he's with a three. On.
No good, and Averill Ugbo with the rebound. Yeah, you can't shoot 46% from the charity stripe.
And be a point guard.
And be a point guard. Kick ball, and Chase Cormier chases it down. Shot up and good by Raymond Brown.
That's Ramon Brown. What can Brown do for you? He can knock down the tray if you don't step up. Hand down, man down.
Still haven't put the points up on the board yet. It's 27-22, 5:57 remaining here in the first half of play. Here's a shot from Prairie View. Up, no good. Ball is tipped, and Irv Mitchell coming away with it.
Yeah, that looks like it's going to be on Zachary Hamilton as he was aggressively going for the ball, and Irvin Mitchell just out-hustled him, got there, and drew the contact.
Going to the line for the Grambling Tigers, Irv Mitchell. Now they have the score right on the scoreboard. Free throw by Irv, good. 9-for-10 now.
Irvin Mitchell is a pretty solid player. He and Ramon Brown give you the same things on both ends of the floor. Great athleticism, aggressive, smart players on the defensive end, and they tend not to force the ball on offense. They take what the defense gives them in most instances, unless it's just an act of desperation. Both smart players, both very athletic players who use that to their advantage as well.
Some kind of a warning, I think, on...
There might have been a little bit of conversation going on out there, you know, saying that's what it looks like. Looks like these guys were getting involved in some extracurriculars. That can happen oftentimes when you're dealing with young men in competition. And it looks like Ugba may have to sit down for a minute to calm down. But it does look like those guys were involved in a little conversation that didn't have a whole lot to do about basketball.
No, Jesus either. Averill Ugba and Sharon Jett exchanging pleasantries, so to speak. And both Jett and Ugba will have a seat. Free throw up and no good by Irv Mitchell. Prairie View with the basketball. 28-22, 5:38 remaining in the first half. Ball is tipped, thrown out to Hamilton. Shot up and no good by Javonta Blakely as he drove the paint, coming away with it to the Grambling Tigers. Mitchell to Chase Cormier. Cormier will drive, he'll shoot, no good. Rebound by Deontay Jones to Raymond Brown for three. Good!
That's downtown Brown again, knocking down the open lip off the Cormier miss. Cormier penetrating, and Deontay Jones getting the board. And Ramon Brown wide open, knocks it down effortlessly. 31-22, Grambling, 4:50 remaining in the half.
With the ball, Bellinger takes a shot up, no good. Drake Wilkes with the rebound for the Grambling Tigers.
What an alley-oop!
As my brother LeBron Thomas would say, yambone, yambone, have you heard? That's got to be a yam because the sweet potato don't shake like that.
That was from Chase Cormier to Raymond Brown, electrifying the crowd. And now Prairie View wants a 30-second timeout to gather themselves.
Big-time alley-oop, Chase Cormier. As we look at the replay, pushing it up the floor, makes eye contact with Brown and lets it go, and saying it actually looked like he was going to overthrow him, but I did not know that Brown was getting up that high. I knew he could leap, but man, he went up so high, I thought he'd come to save the day.
33-22 now, 4:36 remaining until halftime. What a job there by those two. And this is the kind of momentum they have to keep up, though.
Most definitely. Good to see Grambling putting on an exhibition here in the Hobdy Assembly Center with an 11-point lead, 33-22, with just under 4:30 in the first half.
Prairie View with the basketball. Lots of pressure put on by Grambling. Lomax to Giddings. Three-pointer by Bellinger, no good. Chase Cormier with the rebound. Cormier to Raymond Brown. Back out to Cormier. Bellinger now starting to play the passing lane a little bit more aggressively. Now to Brown. Thought about the three-pointer. Pulls back. Will drive the paint. Ball is hit. And Drake Wilkes with the rebound. 8 seconds left on the shot clock. Oh, it's going to be a travel on Drake Wilkes.
Yeah, he just lost the handle. He got trapped on his hip. No fault of his own. No, Wilkes just lost control of the ball as he was looking at the shot clock and rushing to try to get it. Getting in a position to get an easy basket.
A 10-2 run here by the Grambling Tigers in the last 4 minutes of this ball game. 3:50 remaining until halftime. We'll take this 1 minute timeout. The Grambling Tigers on top, 33-22. 1 minute timeout. We'll be right back.
Grambling State University, continuing our legacy in sports.
At a time of racism and prejudice with widespread in sports, former football player Ernie Davis used his best athleticism skills and became the first African-American winner of the Heisman Trophy in 1961 while playing at Syracuse University.
Welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center on the campus of Grambling State University. Tigers on top, 33-22. Prairie View with the basketball. Giddings now getting it to Blakely. Blakely goes back to the far side of the right side of the floor. Now to Zachary Hamilton, who goes in for the shot, and he's going to be fouled. And that foul is going to be against Deontay Jones, it looks like.
I think that's Jones' second foul.
It is a second foul. It's the fifth team. And going to the line for Prairie View will be number 14, Zachary Hamilton. Hamilton averaging 78% from the free throw line. As a team, nearly 70%. for Prairie View A&M. Irv Mitchell coming back into the ball game. Will take out Carlton Lowe. 3:29 remaining in this first half of the ball game. 33-23 the score. Texas Southern, the best free throw shooting team in the conference at 72.9%. Prairie View coming right behind them at 69. Southern at 68. And I might add, Southern, boy, they've hit a little bit of a problem themselves. They lost to Pine Bluff the other night in Pine Bluff, 68-61.
Wow.
That was a huge loss for them on the road.
I know Coach Roman Banks wasn't happy about that one.
Drake Wilkes, a little off-balance shot up, no good. Ball tipped around, and he comes down to Prairie View. Nice shot by Blakely going coast to coast.
That kid Blakely is aggressively attacking the basket every time. He is not bashful about getting to the bucket, and he can score too.
Chase Cormier can't hit an open layup, and it comes the other way. Oh, they're going to call a blocking foul on Deontay Jones.
Yeah, Cormier was unable to finish on the other end. Great pass, though, from Irvin Mitchell. And then coming right back down, Deontay Jones picks up his third foul.
And honestly, I can't argue with the call by the official.
And we got 2:43 remaining. Grambling up 33-26. Well, they were leading 33-22, have given up 4 points, have not scored, and now they're sending one of the PV players to the line.
Avery Lugbo will come in. Deontay Jones will have a seat. And he's talking to a couple of the coaches right now and getting a little tutoring. And they just want to calm him down a little bit. Free throw shot up and no good. 33-26, 2:40 remaining in the first half of play. Cormier gets his pocket pick. Looked like he was trying to go up for the shot. Up and good. What a finger roll by Tevin Bellinger. As it looked like he was hit with one hand and goes in with a finger roll with the other.
Yeah, Bellinger's a solid player. He's a senior at PV and has been a major contributor to what little success they've had. Plays great defense, got a good-looking stroke, and as we see him playing passing lane, getting the steal, Bellinger going up, and Irvin Mitchell says, get that shot out of here. Bellinger, Bellinger gets his shot swatted, as Irvin Mitchell says, back to sender.
Coach Walker upset with the team right now just because they're just not executing the way they need to on offense here in this last 2 minutes. It was an 11-point lead, now back down to five. And we talked about this, Leon, with Grambling having the propensity to lose leads and lose momentum, and now Prairie View scored six in a row.
Exactly.
Oh, they call a cheap foul.
Looked like Ramon Brown got all ball. The official saw it differently. But again, I'm pleased with the defense to see the Tigers not allowing Prairie View to just effortlessly walk into the lane without at least challenging them defensively.
Irv Mitchell was charged with the foul. The senior from New York, New York, went to Genesee College, or Community College, I should say. Free throw up and good by Zachary Hamilton coming into the ball game for the Panthers. Levante Davis. Cleveland, Ohio went to Hillcrest Prep. ...33-28 our score. Second free throw is up and good. 33-29, they've cut that lead now down to four. 1:50 remaining in the contest, or in the first half of play, I should say.
And see, these are the things that just ruffles Coach Walker's feathers, to watch that lead dwindle down from 11 to 3. I would love to be a fly on the wall at halftime.
Walls may shake a little bit.
That's what I'd expect.
Avery Ludwig trying to set a pick. Chase Cormier has the rock. gets it to Drake Wilkes. Bounce pass to Averill Ugma. Goes up for the shot. No good. He's fouled.
Hard foul, too. Ugma goes to the floor. Foul against number 15, Nolan Wilson, redshirt junior, 6'6", from Laredo, Texas. And Ugma has been shooting pretty well from the charity stripe. Hopefully he can knock these two down.
Nolan Wilson with his third personal, according to what the scoreboard says. Coming in the ballgame for Prairie View A&M will be Hamilton. And Tellinger also comes back in the ball here. Bellinger. He comes into the ball game for Avery Lomax, the senior from DeSoto, Texas. Ugwa with the free throw up and good. 34-30 now the score. 1:23 remaining here in this first half of play. Giddings picks up his dribble, and here's a steal by Irv Mitchell. Mitchell goes in, can't get the bucket. Ball tipped, and Prairie View recovers. Gosh, you got to hit those.
Yes, and it looked like Irv had Carlton low on the other side, but rather than pass it, he went and tried to take it all away himself. Not a wise decision on that particular instance.
Raymond Brown for three, no good. Ball up in the air. Averill Ugma with the rebound. Goes in for the shot, up and no good, but he'll go to the free throw line.
Ugma again attacking the boards on the defensive and offensive end as we take a look at the replay on GSU TV. Ball off the rim. He goes up amongst three Panthers, pulls it down, and immediately goes back up, getting the foul. Averill Ugma has been playing with a renewed spirit.
Free throw up. Good. Drake Wilkes coming into the lineup, and Irv Mitchell will come out for a second. And Deontay Jones getting ready to check back in. He's got to be careful with three fouls. Ugma two for two at the line. Boy, he is shooting lights out from the charity stripe.
And saying you need that in your big man. You need your big man to be able to knock down free throws. That's a great luxury to have because he is going to be getting a lot of attention when we have the ball on the low post, especially with him scoring like he has been lately.
Prairie View the basketball. Raymond Brown with a near steal there. Tevin Bellinger now with the ball out high. Going to the right. Now bounce pass inside, trying to get it to Levante Davis. He goes out of bounds.
Again, we've got to credit the Tigers with the increase of the defensive pressure as we see Ivy Smith Jr. and Carlton Lowe coming back into the game on the floor with them. Ramon Brown, Deontay Jones, and Drake Wilt. 18.6 seconds left, folks. GSU with a 6-point lead, 36-30 over PV. Probably going to play for the last shot. Shot clock is off.
Nice job, Deontay Jones. Inside shot with 2 seconds left. Here's a heave. And that's it for the first half. Grambling Tigers on top by the score of 38-30 going into the halftime locker room. We'll take this 2-minute timeout.
Check, 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 check.
Here with GSU TV, and I'm here with head basketball coach of the Prairie View Panthers. Coach, now you guys are currently down by 8 points. This is a very crucial game for both of you guys. Can you tell us what you're going to say to motivate your team in the locker room?
Our defense has to pick up. I mean, you know, they're out rebounding us, they're out hustling us. We can't get anybody on Brown, we can't stop the big guy on the inside. So my message to them at halftime is going to be that we have to pick up the defense or we're not going to have a chance in this basketball game.
Well, thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
Thank
you, guys.
Welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center on the campus of Grambling State University. The Grambling Tigers on top here at halftime by the score of 38-30. Leon, of course, is being entertained by what's called the Tigerettes.
Yes, a dance squad or a pep squad or whatever the case is. Out here entertaining the exciting dance moves, very intricate. And indeed, a sight for sore eyes. To put it mildly.
All right, take a look at the scoreboard here, of course, from ESPN television. Women's basketball, of course, UConn going for their 100th straight victory, if I'm not mistaken. But right now being challenged by South Carolina, 29-28 in the first quarter. That game is close and still early. Second quarter, actually, it's a minute 57 remaining there.
Still very early. Can anybody beat the Lady Huskies?
I don't know. Texas beat Florida State in women's basketball 92-88. That's a huge upset. Florida State was the number four team in the country. West Virginia right now on top of Kansas 39-32 at halftime. DePaul, I should say Villanova beating DePaul right now 37-16 in the first half. Louisville getting by Syracuse in overtime 76-72. And Texas Tech beat Baylor 84-78, the final score there. The Oklahoma City Thunder, after losing a tough game to Golden State Saturday, not getting any better today. They're down 30 to the Washington Wizards.
Wow.
93-63, and there's still 4:48 left in the third quarter. And the Warriors with a little bit of a letdown. They're down 3:05 left in the second quarter, 68-49. The score there. So let's get you up to date on the scoreboard. Let's get you a little information here from the Southwestern Athletic Conference. Game's going on right now. Halftime, Arkansas Pine Bluff and Alcorn State tied at 39 and a half. Southern right now, a little trouble with Valley on the road, 35-33 at the half. And Jackson State right now, 36-30 on top of Texas Southern at the half.
That's an amazing thing right there. Especially the Southern score. I know Coach Roman Banks is not pleased with the performance of his team right now. And Texas Southern, number one in the conference, a solid squad. Finding them trailing at this point is almost unbelievable. They got a great squad, solid team, a lot of guys who can pretty much score the ball at will. So to see them trailing right now, that's very surprising.
Couple of scores to report. Only two scores right now to report on the women's basketball side. Prairie View, the Grambling beat Prairie View 60-50.
You got So it's the killers. Okay, you got three shots. It's five, four, three, two, shoot. Okay, no, 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 no.
Welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center on the campus of Grambling State University. Joined by Leon Thomas III, I'm Santoria Black. Let's take a look at some of the first half numbers for both the Grambling Tigers and Grambling A&M University Panthers. First of all, for the Grambling Tigers, led in scoring by Raymond Brown, who has 17 points and 2 rebounds. Avery Lugwell already a double-double, 14 points and 10 rebounds. He's 8-for-9 from the free throw line.
Ugba and Ramon Brown have pretty much been the catalyst that have led the ship that is the Grambling State University men's basketball team tonight. Ugba came out aggressive offensively, hitting the glass, and his ability to score points in the paint has opened up those scoring opportunities for Ramon Brown, slashing to the bucket and hitting open jump shots as well.
And you look at the rebounding edge definitely goes to Grambling, 21-8 as far as rebounding, Grambling 9-2 in second chance points. But when you start looking at some of the other things, turnovers 10-9, Grambling has 10 turnovers on the ball game, but they're shooting 12-for-22 from the field. When you look at this score, 38-30, you think, well, maybe they should be up a little bit more. But Prairie's done a very good job at the free throw line themselves, 12-of-13 from the charity stripe in the first half. They've just been out rebounded just tremendously. Also, the other thing to look at is that they've also done a little bit more as far as steals. They've been able to get the ball a little bit more.
True indeed. Grambling later in the game, being careless with the ball, turning it over. Things that Sean Walker, our head coach, despises.
Oh,
but
yeah.
Also a testament to his coaching acumen, the rebounding advantage for Grambling. He is really big about hitting the glass and protecting the ball. It seems as if that message about hitting the glass has come through. Ugba isn't the only one to have that many rebounds. It takes a team effort. Glad to see Grambling crashing the boards and doing the little things right.
Second half getting ready to start here. 38-30 our score. The Grambling Tigers on top. And looks like the Tigers will get the ball to start the second half of the ball game. as the officials get ready for play here in the second half. And we are underway second half action. Tigers need a half where they can keep that lead. Chase Cormier with the ball on the far side. Nice pick set by Averlug, but got to be careful about the moving screen. Cross-court pass to Irv Mitchell. Thought about the three, now will drive. Goes in for the shot, it's up, it's good. 10-point lead now.
Big time move from Irvin Mitchell as he dribbles to the center of the court. Pump fakes, gets his player up, and just up and under. Great move from Irvin Mitchell. Great defense from Grambling, making Prairie View work for everything.
Tevin Bellinger shot up, no good, and Chase Cormier comes away with the basketball. Shot up, no good, and a foul coming up, and it'll be charged to Prairie View, shooting foul. It's going to be charged, it looks like, to number 21. Check that again. Yeah, it's going to be on Sharon Jett.
And Sam, we see Irvin Mitchell starting the second half being offensively aggressive. The first possession immediately attacked the rim, didn't settle for the jump shot, pump fake up and under. This time, attacking the basket again, getting the foul, getting to the line, and knocking down the first free throw.
Another free throw coming up here for Cormier, or I should say for Irv Mitchell. Biggest thing here in the second half, they just have to play really good on defense, make the free throws, execute on offense.
Definitely, and continue to crash the boards.
Two for two at the line. Yeah, the boards, they have just dominated the rebounding edge. It's just been sick. 21-8. They're out-rebounding them on the offensive boards, 8-2, and on the defensive boards, 13-6.
And glad to see Grambling putting up a full-court press, now going to a man-to-man, making Prairie View have to start their offense higher on the court and later in the shot clock than they want to.
Jet with the shot up, no good. No black shirts around. And with the rebound, Raymond Brown. One game for the Tigers next week. They take on Jackson State Saturday. Three-pointer by Drake Wilkes. No good. Ball tipped around. It goes out of bounds off of Abram Ugba. And Coach Sean Walker telling Drake Wilkes, no, don't need that three-pointer right now.
Yeah, Drake Wilkes eyeing up the three. He's got a good-looking stroke, but at this point, it was an early shot in the shot clock. Those are the types of things that Coach Walker wants Grambling's basketball team to do, is to make smart plays. You know, it's a little bit too early in the shot clock. That was actually the first pass.
42-30 the score, 18-16 remaining in the ball game. Shot up, no good. Tevin Bellinger will go to the free throw line.
Bellinger aggressively attacking the basket, going right at Ramon Brown, trying to kiss it out the window with the left hand. Bellinger, a 6-foot senior guard from Hutto, Texas. I remember seeing him play, and this kid's got a good looking stroke. A solid offensive player, hustles a lot on defense as he knocks down the first free throw. He can be a problem late in the game if we mess around and keep it too close.
I'll tell you somebody that they miss, and that's Daquan Cook. He played 16 games, started 14, averaging double figures at almost 11 points a ball game, but he really added a different dimension, not so much on the rebounding side, but here's a kid who was the second-best free-throw shooter on the team at 77%. They lost him, I believe, just shortly after the semester was over with. So missing a guy like Daquan Cook, who's still one of the top scorers on the team, is something to be said. Nice shot, finger roll by Irv Mitchell. He couldn't get the shot to go down. And Coach Sean Walker all over the officials about not calling that. Tevin Bellinger, a three-pointer, good.
And again, Bellinger heating up, Santoria. We saw it last play, went right to Bellinger. ISO one-on-one, got the foul. Went to the line right then, another ISO, one dribble pull up. At 42-35, 17-33 remaining. We got to keep an eye on Bellinger.
Irv Mitchell couldn't get the shot to go down.
And Irvin Mitchell aggressively attacking the basket, That's three times down the floor. There's three shots for Mitchell. He got the foul, going to the line, and hopefully knock down both free throws.
Free throw coming up. Good by Irv Mitchell. 68% free throw shooter. Ivy Smith, about a 77% free throw shooter. He's been to the line 35 times this year. Avery Lugba actually has been to the line second most.
And so Irvin Mitchell misses the second free throw, but Drake Wilkes with a heads-up play. The ball was actually being rebounded by number 24, Jordan Lumpkins, and Drake Wilkes comes from behind him, knocked the ball off his hands.
They're going to call jump ball possession for Avery.
How do you call a jump ball when the guy's behind the kid? You know, that's very confusing to me. Very confusing to me.
Coming into the ball game for Prairie View is Sharon Jett. Giddings will take the paint, goes up. That's going to be a foul coming up.
And that was a great penetration by Giddings. He actually got right to the teeth of the defense, drew three, kicked it out to the right. And that was Jordan Lumpkins, who was just unable to complete the great handoff.
At the line for Prairie View, Sharon Jett. First free throw is up and good.
43-36, Grambling Sam with 17 minutes remaining. I like the energy defensively. I'd like to see us get more players involved than Irvin Mitchell here in the second half, as he's been dominating the ball up to this point. We don't want to let anybody else get cold. We want to keep everyone warm, because we may need to pull from each pot late in the game.
Raymond Brown, it comes to mind. Tigers with a 6-point lead, 43-37. Drake Wilkes. Oh, is it a safe travel?
They called Drake Wilkes for steps as he was looking for his shot.
That's a tough call.
Very tough call, Sam. Very tough call. Turnovers are going to hurt. 43-37. Again, the lead is getting shorter and shorter as the game progresses.
Had to reset the shot clock, I believe. .16:45 remaining in the ball game. 43-37. Prairie View pushing the ball. Here's a three-pointer up, no good. And rebound in the
front back. Amazing rebound! Oh my God!
And that was 21. Sharon Jett with the rebound in the putback, score the bucket.
And, you know, Sam, what made it amazing was that right at the peak of his jump, he got his hands on the ball and just look at the flicker of this. And flicked it right back in before he came down with it, got the foul simultaneously. A big-time play right there as he knocks down the free throw.
Coming into the ball game now for Prairie View A&M is number 15, Nolan Wilson, the redshirt junior, 6'6", from Laredo, Texas.
And saying the lead has been cut now to 43-40. And this is the time where we really, really need a bucket.
Avery Lugba. Back out to Raymond Brown. Irv Mitchell for three. No good. Rebound by Prairie View. It was 38-30 at half, now 43-40.
Cormier is going to need some help. They've got a mismatch down low on the post.
Three-pointer by Bellinger, up no good. Rebound the tip is no good. Bellinger comes around with the rebound. Raymond Brown gets the rebound off of the missed shot from Avery Lomax. Wow, Irv Mitchell not finally called a blocking foul. Coach Byron Smith not happy.
And, you know, that was a good call for Grambling right there, because Irvin Mitchell actually lost the ball. And had it not been for that call, it would have resulted in a turnover.
Timeout on the floor with the score. Grambling 43, Prairie View 40. We'll take this one-minute timeout. 1 minute. You're listening to the Grambling Sports Radio Network and watching this live on GSU TV.
Grambling State University, continuing our legacy in sports.
Retired basketball player, coach, and general manager Willis Reed's momentous physical force at an early age led him into a basketball career, both collegiate and professional. While at Grambling, Willis led the Tigers to one National Association of Intercollegiate Athletics title and three Southwestern Conference championships. In 1964, the New York Knicks selected Willis in the second round of the NBA draft. Throughout his career, Willis proved to be a remarkable player, and in 1970, he was inducted into the NAIA Basketball Hall of Fame.
Welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center on the campus of Grambling State University, the Tigers.
Grambling State University, continuing.
Yeah, and Irvin Mitchell's at the free throw line, knocks down the first one. Centauri, the offense has been a little bit stagnant in the second half thus far. Got to continue to build on that lead and not make the kinds of mistakes that allows this Prairie View Panther team to creep back in, as Irvin Mitchell's 2-for-2 from the line. 15:30 remaining, 45-40 in favor of Grambling.
45-40 the score. Prairie View looking. Oh, it's going to be a foul coming up, charged to Grambling.
Yeah, they called Irvin Mitchell on the foul. If you're looking at GSU TV, taking a look at the replay, Irvin Mitchell on the reach in. Reaches out and grabs Blakely, and Blakely's going to the line to shoot two.
First free throw coming up here by Blakely. And it's up, it's no good off the front of the iron. A rare miss. One more free throw opportunity and going out of the ball game. I think the cold is now getting to me.
Yeah, it's a little chilly in here. And it must have affected Blakely as well, because he missed both free throws. And we see Nigel Ribeiro going to the scorer's table. And he's entering into the game, giving Irvin Mitchell a breather. So on the floor right now, you've got Chase Cormier, Nigel Ribeiro, last year's freshman of the year in the conference, Carlton Lowe, Deontay Jones, and Richwood, Louisiana's own Ramon Brown.
Bellinger with the basketball. Lots of dribbling going on. Oh, Deontay Jones picks up his fourth.
That was just Bellinger creating offense. Bellinger handling the ball, drawing, dishing, kicking it to the slashing Blakely, and they really caught Jones in a no-win situation. He either had to give the ball up or make the foul.
First free throw up and good, and now Jones has to sit down with four, and Drake Wilkes will come back into the ball game.
Blakely's second free throw is good. 14-14 17:52 remaining, 45-42, GSU over PV.
Blakely only a 59% free throw shooter. Didn't look like that.
Cormier turns it over. Ribeiro saves it. Kicks it to Brown. Brown and Bellinger going head up. Brown shot off the iron. No good.
Out of bounds off of Prairie View. Back to Grambling. Great hustle for the ball. You see on the replay from GSU TV, Carlton Lowe had the ball, and Giddings actually tipped it out. Chase Cormier coming down with the ball.
Carlton Lowe with the one dribble pull up off the iron. No good.
And it comes down to Prairie View A&M. 45-42, 14-16 remaining in the ball game. Ball goes out of bounds off of Grambling back to Prairie View.
And it's good to see. It's good to see. It was Grambling's ball. Nobody hit it. He just threw it right out of bounds to the coach.
So it is Grambling's ball.
And it's good to see Carlton Lowe looking for his shot a little bit more, saying he's got a good-looking stroke. Gave one good pump fake. The guy bit on it, took the dribble, and pulled up. Lowe's out now. And we've got Averill Ugba back in on the floor with Drake Wilkes, Nigel Ribeiro, Chase Cormier, and Ramon Brown.
Nigel Ribeiro, left side to Cormier. Inside to Ugba. He is double-teamed big time.
And Ugba is forced to call the timeout. Very, very intense defense from the Prairie View A&M Panthers. And they caught Ugba in a bad situation on the baseline. Coach Byron Smith pleased with the defensive intensity of his team, as you see him clapping as they come to the huddle.
We'll take a one-minute timeout as well. One-minute timeout with the score, Grambling 45, Prairie View 42. 1 minute, we'll be right back. Welcome back here to the Frederick C. Hobby Assembly Center on the campus of Grambling State University. Tigers on top, 45-42. Shot clock winding down. Raymond Brown with a three, no good. And the rebound pulled down by Prairie View A&M University. And getting the rebound was Jadonta Blakely.
And Grambling's holding on to a three-point lead right now, saying with 13:35 remaining. Got to make some defensive stops, but have to convert on the offensive side.
Avery Lomax with the basketball, now to Tevin Bellinger. Bellinger with a shot, nice shot up, no good, and the rebound by Drake Wilkes.
And that was great defense from Ramon Brown. Bellinger putting on a lot of nifty moves, but Brown contested the shot, didn't give him anything.
Nigel Ribeiro with a nice little jumper, 10 feet out, it's good.
Great shot from Ribeiro, knocking down the little bunny right there, making his presence felt already.
Bellinger, three-pointer on the way, no good. And it's going to be a foul on Drake Wilkes.
And Bellinger's shot in and out. It went down, but it came right back up. And if that thing starts staying down, we might be in for a long night.
Well, it's going to be a foul coming up on Drake Wilkes, and it's going to be a non-shooting foul. And for Drake Wilkes, I believe that's going to be number one on him. Bellinger defended by Chase Cormier. Now he gets it to Hamilton. Shot up no good, and Chase Cormier with the rebound. Raymond Brown, nice stop and pop. Can't get the shot to go down. And for the rebound, it's Prairie View A&M. 47-42, 12:30 remaining left in the ball game. Been a long night here at the Assembly Center. Chase Cormier was right there trying to find what's going on. Giddings goes up for the shot. It's no good, and Drake Wilkes with the rebound. Crazy turn of events there. Ball tipped out of bounds off of Prairie View back to Grambling.
Yeah, and Nigel Ribeiro was hesitant about pulling the trigger on that. As we heard all the fans yelling, let it go, too, let it go, too. Everybody knows what he's capable of.
Then he almost threw the ball away. Nigel Ribeiro with the basketball, 22 seconds left on the shot clock. Drake Wilkes. Wilkes, turn around, little baby hook, no good. Ball tipped around and recovered by Zachary Hamilton. Boy, he got to hit those little baby hooks.
Most definitely. Holding on to a 5-point 47-42 lead, under 12 remaining. We cannot make this game any closer.
Giddings with the basketball, now hands it off to Blakely. Three-pointer on the way, it's up, it's no good. Ugba with the rebound for Grambling. Gets it out to Nigel Ribeiro. Ribeiro to Raymond Brown, thought about the three, now pulled back. Gets it to Drake Wilkes. Wilkes takes the baseline. Out to Raymond Brown. Brown to Ugba. Ugba goes in, can't hit the shot, but he's going to the free throw line.
That's right, Ugba. Ugba being aggressive, still on offense, forcing Sharon Jett to foul him.
Timeout on the floor with the score. The Grambling Tigers 47, the Prairie View A&M Panthers 42, with 11:17 remaining in the ball game. We'll take this 1 minute timeout. 1 minute, we'll be right back.
Grambling State University, continuing our legacy in sports.
The Tide basketball player, coach, and general manager Willis Reed's momentous physical force at an early age led him into a basketball career, both collegiate and professional. While at Grambling, Willis led the Tigers to one National Association of Intercollegiate Athletics title and three Southwestern Conference championships. In 1964, the New York Knicks selected Willis in the second round of the NBA draft. Throughout his career, Willis proved to be a remarkable player, and in 1970, he was inducted into the NAIA Basketball Hall of Fame.
State University 47-42 our score, with 11:17 remaining here in the contest. And out on the floor for Grambling, of course, is Ugba, Nigel Ribeiro, Chase Cormier, Raymond Brown, and Drake Wilkes. Ugba with a free throw opportunity, ooh, off the back of the iron, no good.
And these are the times when the free throws are most important, as we see Irvin Mitchell coming back in for Drake Wilkes, and Ugba eyeing the second free throw.
Good.
.48-42 is the lead for Grambling with just over 11 minutes in the game.
Bellinger with the basketball, gets it out to Lomax, then Giddings. Pick getting ready to come out. Steal by Nigel Ribeiro. And it's thrown off of Prairie View. Grambling basketball.
Let's go, 10.
Now Grambling will get another opportunity here. 10:49 left to go in the ball game. And it looks like Yusef Yakubu, along with number 11, Jadonte Blakely, come into the ball game for Prairie View A&M. Ugba getting it to Irv Mitchell. Now to Nigel Ribeiro on the right side. Raymond Brown, oh, tried to get it out to Irv Mitchell, and it was suffocating defense on the inside by Prairie View. Double and triple team down on the baseline. Three-pointer on the way, good.
And that's great shot.
Troy Thompson with the three-pointer, the 6'4 junior from Oakland, California. 48-45 now.
See the three, be the three. You know what I'm saying? We hesitated too long to get Ramon Brown the ball on the last trip down the floor as he had a mismatch with a much smaller player. And by the time we did, the defense just collapsed.
Chase Cormier, three-pointer. It's no good. Raymond Brown with the rebound, and it's thrown off of, looked like it was thrown off of Grambling, or bounced off of Grambling, back to Prairie View A&M.
Yes, taking a look at the replay, he tried to throw it off the defender, and the kid did a great job of getting out of the way.
Yeah, it's not Chase Cormier's shot either, out there at the three-point line. Only 10 of 26 on the season.
And turnover.
Oh, my God. Coast to coast.
Ramon Brown, that's get up to get down. That's got to be jammed because jelly doesn't shake like that.
9:23 remaining in the ball game, and Raymond Brown coast to coast taking two steps and dunking the basketball. And Yokobo travels. It's going to be Grambling basketball.
And another look at the Ramon Brown dunk if you're on GSU TV. That was just raw athleticism from Brown. Just taking two steps and elevating.
I dreamt that I could do that one night.
Likewise.
It's just a dream, though.
Yeah, the only time I ever touched the rim is if we were changing the nets out.
There's going to be a foul coming up, it looks like.
Yeah, that was a foul on looks like number two from Prairie View, as Irvin Mitchell had gotten great position. Ramon Brown hit him with a great dime pass, and he immediately elevated, but the foul was on the floor before the act of shooting.
Chase Cormier will inbound the basketball. Gets it into Drake Wilkes. Gets off that sideline on the far side, which is the right side of the floor. Grambling going from right to left on your radio. Chase Cormier now looking. Now to Irv Mitchell. Back to Chase Cormier. Irv, three, good. 53-45, 8:34 remaining in the ball game.
That's John Trey Bolter for Irvin Mitchell.
Dellinger is going to be fouled. Going to be on Chase Cormier. Should be his first personal.
Yeah, Bellinger attacking the basket aggressively from the baseline. And that is Cormier's second foul, Sam. And Bellinger's going to go to the line.
So Chase has two personal fouls. Ugbe has three. He has 15 points along with Irv Mitchell. Free throws up and good. 53-46, Scranley on top. 8:27 left in the ball game. Free throw 17-22 for Grambling, 19-22 for Prairie View.
Some excellent free throw shooting tonight between these two ball clubs who are fighting for playoff positioning in the Southwestern Athletic Conference tournament.
Yeah, there's no question because the winner of this ball game will get to six wins. Benchmark probably is eight or nine. I'd say probably eight at this point.
And saying, you know, Ugba has already recorded 11 rebounds as well.
Chase Cormier to Drake Wilkes. Now to Irv Mitchell. Nine left on the shot clock. Chase Cormier. Chase Cormier goes in and draws a foul.
And if you're re-looking at the play on GSU TV on the replay, Cormier with a great aggressive move to the left side. Tried to kiss it off the window, but got the contact.
7:59 remaining in the ball game. 53-47. Grambling still holding on. We'll take this 1 minute timeout. We'll be right back. Thank you.
thought it was great. I thought Beyonce had a great performance, especially for someone who is with child, and the message that she was trying to send as well. And, of course, I love the performance from A Tribe Called Quest featuring Anderson .Paak, and, of course, Busta Rhyme was there as well. Those are hip-hop guys from our generation.
And then, of course, Chance the Rapper doing some great things, all those Grammys, and he's an independent artist. And, performed with Kirk Franklin and Tamela Mann.
Yeah, Tamela Mann is an amazing vocalist, man. I would pay to hear her sing if she were singing the alphabet.
Nice job by Giddings. Tries to get to around Raymond Brown and gets the ball blocked out of there. 55-47 after the made free throws on the other side. Giddings just going right around but still gets the ball blocked out of there. Now Tevin Bellinger with the basketball.
That was just great defense from Ramon Brown.
Blakely looking inside. Right side to Thompson, three-pointer up and no good. Yokobu with the rebound. Goes up for the shot, he gets the bucket.
Easy put back for Yokobu. No one was down there except for Irvin Mitchell, and he has him by about 4 or 5 inches. So all he had to do was just kiss it off the window. 55-49, Grambling, just over 7 minutes left in the game.
Chase Cormier looking left, and boy, Yokobu really putting the defense on Ugba. Inside to Irv Mitchell, goes up for the shot, no good. And they're going to call a foul on Grambling and not a jump ball. And for Chase, that's going to be, what, 3 on him, I believe?
I think you are correct. That is correct, Sam. 3 fouls.
3 for Chase, 3 for Ugba now. 1-1 situation. And so now we start having a bonus at the rest of this ball game.
And, you know, that's going to come in very handy. Going to see how aggressive Grambling stays on the defensive side of the ball since the Panthers will be shooting free throws for the next 7:04.
Hey, boy!
Missed the free throw, and Yokobu was not called for a foul. He was over the back. Here comes Nigel Rivera with the shot. It's up. It's no good. The rebound. And Yokobu goes down. And that is a 5-on-4. And now I got an injured player on the other side.
Avery, good job.
Yeah, it looks like Yokobu is hurt. And everybody's coming out of the Grambling staff as well as the Prairie View A&M staff just to make sure that that he's okay. It looks like he might have taken a shot to the face, but he shook it off. It seems to be okay. Yokobu is a 6'7 junior forward from Buffalo, New York. He's back to his feet, seems to be okay.
So it'll be Prairie View A&M basketball, and now there'll be a replacement here for Yokobu, and that's going to be Sharon Jett from Hartsville, South Carolina.
What's good, 11?
Blakely will inbound the basketball, and we'll get it out to Tevin Bellinger. Blakely got the ball knocked out of his hands. Goes all for Prairie View and back to Grambling.
Great defense by Ramon Brown. As Blakely went up, Brown just swiped at it and knocked it away from him. Blakely tried to recover but couldn't secure the ball.
Looked like he was saying swipe or no swiping. I didn't swipe the ball. Grambling with the basketball, 6:20 remaining in the ball game. Cormier on the near side, left side near the press table. Now back over to Raymond Brown. Brown in between the circles, looking for Nigel Bell. Now he goes through. Irv Mitchell with the basketball. He's defended by Blakely. Irv Mitchell, a shot up, no good. The rebound, the putback, good by Ugba. And a shot with a three-point play coming up.
And saying, you know, I've been watching the play between Ugba and Yokobu. You know, it's been some really good paint work down there. A lot of good big boy play, fighting for positioning with these two guys. Yakubu trying to front Ugba. Ugba constantly fighting for a position, staying active, moving his feet, getting good position to put himself to tip in that missed shot. Great play by Ugba tonight.
Good work by our TV crew, GSU TV, watching it on YouTube.
Yeah, shout out to GSU TV and Mr. Allen Blakeney and Lanita Hughes.
Yeah, she's all right. When is she going to get a good at this?
All right, sideline reporter for the
three-pointer by Blakely is good. That Thompson. I think that's his third three-pointer of the night.
Yeah, Thompson has been able to knock that shot down with relative ease, and he's a junior from Oakland, California, and he's had a sweet stroke all night long.
Thompson shooting 40% from the three-point line. He is probably their best free throw shooter next to Zachary Hamilton.
And Cormier gets the ball knocked away, still Grambling ball, 5:30. We've got a six-point ball game, Sam, 58-52. It's still anybody's game.
5:30 remaining in the contest. Cormier bounce pass into Irv Mitchell. Out of bounds off of Grambling. Back to Grambling. Nigel Brown was trying to do some heroics as the shot clock expired.
Yeah, tried to shoot the reverse layup. A little bit too much traffic underneath the basket.
Kellinger got the ball blocked out of his hands. Now Giddings has it. Oh, he took the trip with it.
Yeah, that Bellinger went to the hole on Ramon Brown, and that's when Brown showed those explosive hops. Out of nowhere, as we take a look on the replay, is Ramon Brown coming through with the block. Great defensive stop that time by the Grambling Tigers. What?
And Nigel Ribeiro got his pocket pick. Here comes Bellinger out to Thompson. Thompson gets the three-pointer, and it's now 58-55. He has 12 points. All of them have come from the three-point line.
And let me tell you something. Thompson's stroke is as sweet as maple syrup. He's knocked down four threes tonight, and saying he got the ball and backed it out to the three-point line on a two-on-one break, which lets you know how confident he is in that jumper.
Ugba can't hit the shot. Fairview with the rebound can bring it to within one or tie the ball game. 4:15 remaining in the contest. Timeout, Fairview.
Saying, and again, little mistakes coming down, taking shots early in the shot clock, not converting, turnovers by trying to force the issue the last time up the floor. The last two times, Nigel Ribeiro attacked the basket, tried to shoot a reverse layup, too much traffic, nothing doing. The next time, tried to penetrate through a trap. One of the players from PV got a hand on the ball, turnover, led to a Thompson three-pointer. Those are the types of things that Grambling cannot afford to do late in the game.
Yeah.
4 minutes and 11 seconds, those types of mistakes can end up being costly mistakes that can cost you the game at this point when we've led for so long up to this point.
Well, I'll tell you what, one of the things that this Grambling Tiger team will have to do with 4:11 remaining in the contest, they have got to make sure that they start taking care of the basketball, and also they got to make sure they're getting more rebounds. You know, they're out rebounding Fairview right now, but they've got to do a much better job of making sure they're not getting those three-pointers on the other end. Thompson has been shooting the three. You got to get out there on him. He's probably one of their best three-point shooters.
Yeah, Thompson has been he's been like the ATM, and that's automatic money. He's been knocking it down every time he touched the ball. A player that, if I were in that huddle, I'd be telling my guys, know where one is all night long. Keep your eyes on one, and somebody try to stay in front of five. If you notice what PV and Coach Smith is doing right now, he's keeping a lot of scorers on the floor. You know, number 11, Blakely, can get to the hole with relative ease. You got Bellinger, who can penetrate, who can shoot. And then you got Thompson, who has proven himself thus far to be a dead-eye three-point shooter at least tonight.
Lakely with the basketball. Thompson, a long three again, this time off the mark. And Prairie View steps on the end line, getting the rebound. It goes back to Grambling.
Hell no.
Yeah, that was a long, long three-pointer. And it just hit the front of the rim. Just hit the front of the rim.
Yeah.
And he shot that one from so far out, man. I thought he might have been downtown.
Chase Cormier waving Nigel Ribeiro through. Chase goes up for the shot, no good. Raymond Brown tried to get the rebound. It's up, it's no good. The foul coming up.
Hey, foul!
Yeah, that was a great play. Chase Cormier with the penetration. Brown tried to dunk it back in to no avail, but Ugbo was right there. As we take a look at the replay, Ugbo right there, and Ugbo put it on the floor. And Bellinger actually hit the ball and got a little bit of Ugbo in the process as he's at the line to shoot, too.
First free throw is up and good, and that's for Bellinger. That's his first personal.
And Ugba's been pretty reliable from the charity stripe again, as I stated earlier. That's a great luxury to have when you've got a big man who can knock down his free throws as he knocks down both free throws.
Well, I tell you what, the Tigers shooting pretty well at the charity stripe. 60-55, back out to a five-point lead. Somebody's going to have to keep an eye on Thompson. He can shoot the three. Chase Cormier out there on Thompson. Now out to Blakely. Back to Bellinger. Three-pointer on the way, no good. Ugbo with the rebound.
Way to crash the boards by Ugbo. Bellinger's shot rolled around and touched every part of the rim, and Ugbo was right there when it fell off.
Yeah. Going to be a foul charge to 21, Sharon Jett. Yeah, 60-55, our scores. 2:51 remaining here.
Shut up, Flamingo.
In this ball game.
Send you home.
And it's great to see Ugba staying aggressive all night long, just like he did at the start of the game.
Yeah.
He's played with the same level of intensity from the jump ball to this very moment. Still crashing the boards. Still looking for his shot on the offensive end. And still knocking down free throws as we just see him knock down the first free throw. I've been very impressed, Santoria. Ugba has played an outstanding past three games.
Oh, misses that one. 61-55, six-point deficit for Prairie View. Turnover down there. Ball is on the floor.
Grambling gets the ball. Cormier with the handle at the top of the key.
2:32 remaining, 21 left on the shot clock. Now Bellinger right up on Chase Cormier. Now to Ugbe. Turnover. Ball was too high for Ugbe, and they turned the ball over.
Yeah, mistakes. That was just a high lob if you're looking at it on GSU TV. Just a little bit too high for Ugbe to handle, resulting in a turnover. And PV with the ball with just over 2 minutes left.
Keep it out of Thompson's hands. That's the key. Thompson for three, four.
And that's Thompson again deep in the corner. He is shooting threes like Lamar Mundane, and that's layup.
Thompson has hit five threes. He's got 15 points, 61-58, a minute 47 left in the ball game.
Man, that kid can shoot the three. He's got a good-looking stroke.
Chase Cormier. Not a Raymond Brown. Brown looking. Right elbow. Up. No good. Prairie View can tie or they can go within 1 point. Timeout Prairie View. It's a full timeout. So we'll take a timeout as well. We're going to score 61-58, 1:20 remaining here in the ballgame. We'll take this 1 minute timeout. We'll be right back.
As calm as you can imagine. This kid is 5'6" from Trey, down by three, and he's got an automatic stroke, and Bellinger is still a threat to knock down the three.
A turnover there as Bellinger threw it off of the foot of his teammate. Just going to be a double dribble violation.
Again, you know, those are the kinds of mistakes that eat Coach Walker alive as he is livid on the sidelines. 58 seconds, we are up by 3 points, and we've got a team that's got some solid three-point shooters.
Oh, yeah? You've got Zachary Hamilton, who shoots 40%. You've got 41%. Troy Thompson with 40%. You got some guys that can shoot the three. Bellinger, he's no stranger to shooting the three-pointer. That's going to be a traveling violation, so a turnover now by Braveview.
Yeah, Bellinger drugged the foot. Not pleased with the call. Let's take a look at the replay. He gets right in the lane.
Yeah,
he drugged that left foot a little bit, just was unable to keep it planted, and the officials called him for steps. 39 seconds, Grambling still holding on to a three-point lead.
Yeah, let's go.
Got to come down and convert.
61-58, Tigers with a three-point lead. 8 seconds between the game clock and the shot clock.
Huge possession right here.
Cormier, that one back out to Raymond Brown. Brown looking, got to watch the push-off. Another push-off, got to watch that one. Nigel Ribeiro shoots. Shot is up, no good. And the shot clock violation, 7.9 remaining.
Hey, y'all, the ref got waves.
And you know that, again, Santoria, a wasted possession, if you will, very non-productive on that end. Way too much dribbling at the top of the key, never getting into an offense, if you will, just a lot of useless dribbling. Nigel Ribeiro got caught on no man's land at the top of the key with the shot clock running down and was forced to throw up an ill-advised three-pointer that didn't even hit the rim. You know, those are the kinds of things that Grambling as a ball club has got to improve upon to really, really be competitive in the SWAC conference and the tournament.
We'll take a 1 minute timeout. 1 minute, Tigers on top by three with 8 seconds left in the game. Be right back.
Oh, yeah.
Welcome back here to the Frederick T. Hoppe Assembly Center on the campus of Grambling State University. The Tigers with a big win over Fresno A&M, 61-58. Joining us here at courtside is head coach Sean Walker. Coach, it was ugly at times, but a win is a win.
We make it ugly, I tell you. we can look so good for 10 minutes, make two or three mistakes, and look the worst. You know, we were in control of the game, but we're not in control of the game. You know, we make two or three bad turnovers inside of a minute. We're fortunate to win it.
Coach, one guy that's really played well, especially these last four games, is Abel Ugba, another double-double tonight.
Something's woke Abel up. You know, he works really hard. He comes to campus, comes to the gym, and he's getting one-on-one. And he's a beast, man. He's been a beast the last four games. The best post player in the league. He's been the best post player the last four or five nights on the floor. I'm excited about where he's playing.
You know, one of the things, Coach, that you saw some real flashes of is you saw some flashes of good rebounding, out-rebounding Prairie View A&M tonight.
Yeah, we don't do it enough. You know, we give up pivotal moments where we don't rebound the basketball. But tonight, you know, I think in the first half we were out-rebounding them 21-10. We got to the foul line. And then in the second half we let them back in the game because we didn't rebound. So we're a little undersized. But when we play hard enough and do things the right way, you know, we can have a chance to compete on the backboard.
You talk about free throw shooting and Avril Ugba, another just stellar night. And as a team, you guys shot extremely well, more than 75%.
Well, that's the way for us to win. You know, we have had nights that we did not defend, that we did not make free throws, particularly at Southern. We shot 14-30. But that's the key to winning close games. You're going to win a close game. You're going to have to be able to step to the line and make free throws. And it's about guts. You know, I tell our guys all the time, when the ball stops and the referee calls the foul, it's you, the ball, and everybody's watching. You got to be tough enough to go up there and finish.
And you see on our replay here, Raymond Brown, another great night for him. He was able to step up and do some good things.
He played really well tonight. He always gets our toughest defensive assignment, but he has 17 points in the first half. We look for him. And Irvin Mitchell are playing well, we can be pretty good.
Coach, now you get ready for the three-game stretch. Jackson, Pine Bluff, Valley, not easy. All three teams played pretty well this last weekend. And one of the things I know you tell your guys all the time is that on the road, you got to control the tempo, take them out of the ballgame.
Yeah, we've got to figure out a way to win on the road. You know, I've never seen a league in my 22 years experience that the home court advantage is as major as it is in this league. All of the teams in our league have won at home. The best teams in the league have won on the road. So we've got to figure out a way to win on the road. We've done a pretty decent job at home. And I said to our guys, the championship is not going to be won at Grambling. So we've got to figure out how to go on the road, play solid basketball, and figure out how to win.
Yeah, Southern got beat by Pine Bluff on Saturday. They were trailing at Valley. No matter what, Texas Southern was trailing tonight at Jackson. Yep. I mean, you just never know what's going to happen.
Well, you know, Mississippi Valley seemingly is just as good as anybody in the league, but they're in eighth or ninth place. Mississippi Valley has beaten Texas Southern at Mississippi Valley. They've beaten Alcorn at Mississippi Valley. And I believe they've beaten Southern at Mississippi Valley. That's number one, two, and three. And so they're just as good as anybody, and they're really good at home. And we've been really good at home. We've got to figure out if we're going to be a good team and figure out how to get a win on the road.
Coach, enjoy it. We'll see you at Jackson this weekend.
Thank you so much.
All right, that's it for the for our Coach's Corner. Final score is 61-58. We're going to take a two-minute timeout. When we come back, we'll be back on ESPN 97.7. For those who are watching us on GSU TV, thanks for watching us. We will see you coming up in a couple of weeks when we'll be back here for Senior Night on Thursday, March the 2nd, against Alabama A&M, and then Saturday against Alabama State. We'll take this timeout. Be back to our listeners on ESPN 97.7. Back after this.
Hey, let me get this wire. Let me get this wire. Right?